Welcome back to Fallout 4. We've been chasing a string of distress signals sent out by people from the Brotherhood of Steel. We just found the latest one at the National Guard Training Center here. And now it's time to go check out the satellite array nearby. Probably another body to be found. Scout this place out first, see what we're working with. Looks pretty large. I see a fire over there. Bloatfly. Burning tires, it looks like. You know, I wonder if I can snipe you out of the air. Damn it! You flying bloated bug. Gotcha! That feels good. Okay, oh. Yep, super mutants. I knew it as soon as I saw the bags of bloody body parts. You know, I could probably snipe them from here. I'm a sniper. Let's do it. I wish I could go prone. Most I can do is crouch, though. Whoa. Hello. Thing used to pose such a problem for me before, and now look at it. Oh, look, it's going like sideways. That's so cool. Come here. Come hug me. You know, I just thought of, just like I equipped the collar on dog meat, can I put a hat on dog meat? I don't think so. But I really want to try it now. Do I have any spare hats? Oh, I've got a Coast Guard hat. Dogmeat, come here. I want to see if you can wear a hat.
Hey, over here. Hey.
No, I can't.
Dang.
That would be hilarious if you could.
Hey.
Oh, I also did a bunch of stuff off-screen, by the way. I totally forgot to mention it. What did I do? The main thing I did is I went back to my other settlement at the Starlight Drive-In. I went back there and I started crafting some stuff, because if you remember, I actually turned that into a settlement, and then I just left it. And, of course, there was no water, there was no food, there was only one bed that just happened to already be there. So people were not very happy. So I went back there and I just made some stuff. Made some beds, I made some things. Some defense, a little bit of food. Didn't make any water, though. But just fixed it up a bit, so people should be a little bit happier. Although you can see their happiness is 9%, which is not very good. But it's better than it was before. I also made a recruitment beacon back at Sanctuary, so hopefully we can attract more people there, because I want to expand the size of it. In fact, yeah, there's 6 people there now, so it's already grown. Which means I need to make more beds. But that can wait. Back to this, we need to kill some super mutants. What did you just shoot? A freaking rocket? Missed with that one a little bit. You don't even know where I am. Wow, that must be like a legendary that I'm shooting, because that's taking a lot of hits. And I'm getting headshots too. Oh shit! Dog meat! Get up! Get up, boy! Oh, holy shit! I didn't realize they were coming. Oh my god. I was so laser focused on the ones up there. I didn't realize some were actually coming. Okay. Those super mutants are strong, and I'm carrying an invisible weapon. There we go. Now the weapon's there. Let's try that again. I thought it was so far away that I'd be fine. Alright, well this is before I took my rat away. So my radiation is insanely high. I need to take that again. And the reason I got so irradiated is because when I was at the Starlight Drive-In trying to build stuff, I kept spending time around that putrid pond in the center. Ah, fuck. That was a terrible shot. Gotcha. Okay, let's not go for that legendary one, because it takes too many shots. Let's go for the weaker ones. One shot, one kill. Oh, wait. Oh, no, I just knocked you down. I didn't kill you. There we go. Okay, now they know where I am. Let's watch for the ones. There's the Hellhound. Come on, second shot. Damn it. No! Shot his arm off right before the killing blow went down. Or not the killing blow, probably wouldn't have killed me in one hit, but still. Oh god, oh god. Bomb, bomb, bomb! I'm sorry, dog meat! I'm sorry! You'll be okay. I was gonna blow up at least one of us, I wanted it to be just one, not both. Do we have distance? Yeah, we got distance now. Nobody's running at us. Alright. These are some tough super mutants. Legendary super mutant butcher. Oh, mutated. Ooh, that's a little bit too close for comfort. You still up there, shooting rockets at me? Yeah, there you are. God, they're a terrible shot. There we go. Well, it says caution, so there's gotta be more. Ah, there we go. I like being a sniper. Gotcha. Or made him mutate? That's a legendary enemy too? How many legendary enemies are here? That's gotta be two or maybe three. Where are they now? I don't don't see any movement. Nobody seems to be rushing towards me. In fact, they don't even know where I am. Alright. Let's loot some bodies here and move in. Oh, shit! Hey! Let's get some headshots here. And crit. Let's do a crit. Or miss all my shots? Fuck. Get him, dog meat. Get him, dog meat! You know what? I think this calls for the cryo later. Freeze! Put your hands up! Oh, dog meat. Where are those shots coming from exactly? Legendary Super Mutant Butcher. Yeah, there's another Legendary Super Mutant. Jesus. The land of Legendary Super Mutants. Once again, I'm caution. I'm good. Nobody sees me. Sentinel's leather left arm. Reduces damage while standing and not moving by 15%. It's a kind of a tanky, stand-your-ground kind of piece of armor. Interesting. Let's see what I'm currently wearing on my left arm. I've probably got something special. Yeah, I've got Champion's left arm. Plus one strength and endurance. I'm gonna stick with that. Distress signal found. We know there's at least one enemy left. And they're legendary, so I want to be careful here. Also want to loot this place well, because I want to loot every single legendary person. They have good loot. There's something fascinating about that box, slowly going down the water. Its journey has come to an end. Now it can rest. Where's that legendary super mutant? Oh, that's a hound. Wait, I saw someone up there. Oh, they're actually dead. I thought I just knocked them down. Oh. That's the legendary super mutant, I can tell, because it's smoking.
Stop hiding.
Shit, does a lot of damage. Run! Please don't beat up dog meat, you asshole. Gotcha. Dog meat, you okay? Where is dog meat? Assassin's Pike Rifle. Does 50% more damage against humans. What a racist weapon. Or specious weapon, I guess? There you are, dog meat. No, that's not all the enemies in this place. Danger. Something sees me. Although I don't see it on the compass. This place is gonna take a while to search. Let's search the ground floor first and then start going up the buildings. And be on the lookout for whatever's still left, because there's something left. And I'm about to sneeze, by the way. Ah. Bless me. Missile launcher. That's gotta be heavy. Compensated, calibrated, powerful pipe. Pistol, I think. You go check. This rifle's amazing. Oh, I'm apparently really close to the body. I assume they'd be somewhere up, but maybe they're down below? Is there a down below? No, they're probably up above. There's not too much on the ground floor, I just want to make sure I don't miss any of the bodies. Oh, some little makeshift homes here too. Armor workbench. Let's start going up. I think they might be up there. Ferris's holotape.
2 hours since the paladin left. My leg. I can't staunch the bleeding. The bullet must have hit an artery. Brandis, if you get this, I hope you made it back to Aslan in time. There was nothing you could do for me. Get to the bunker up north. You'll survive. That's all that... all that matters.
This is such a long trail to follow. I like it. So, where's that bunker? Oh, it's all the way up there. All the way at the complete extreme north of the map. Recon Bunker Theta. Alright, well, we can go turn in the Greentop Nursery quest after we're done here, and then keep heading up north and go check it out. I'm really curious what I'm gonna find. Two more structures to climb up, check out, and then we can go turn in the quest. Is that a lighthouse? Looks like it. Yeah, it looks like it's right there.
Nice.
Permanently more difficult to detect while sneaking.
Sweet.
You know, I've been playing this game for like 13, 15 hours or something, and I still press escape to try to go back in menus instead of tab. Oh wait, now there's two more structures to go up, actually. I miscounted the number of structures to vertically climb. I'm a bad minute man. Come on, reach the bloody bag. Oh, rat stag meat, yeah. Ooh, made a little home in a dish here. Power armor, don't give a damn. Fat man. Carrying too much, I knew that thing would be heavy. Let's see how much the super mutant leg armor weighs. I'm assuming it's ridiculously heavy. Weighs 6 compared to like 3? That's not that ridiculously heavy. What about this fat man? Weighs 30. Launches mini nukes. I've actually got a couple mini nukes. It's worth keeping that around, I suppose, in case I need some serious firepower. I don't want to keep it on me though, it weighs too much. I'll keep it on dog meat. For special occasions.
Hey.
Can have Batman. Laser rifle. Missile launcher's also super heavy too. And you can have a super mutant leg armor. And all my junk. I'm still really overweight though. Where'd all that weight come from? Pipe rifle? Ah, that thing doesn't weigh that much. Field scribe's armor? No. I really don't know. Oh well. Let's actually check out that field scribe's armor, see if it's better than what we've got. Nope. It's pretty bad. Seems to require me to take off all my armor, so nah. Oh, also. Coast Guard hat. Well, as cute as that is, that gets rid of my mining helmet, which means I don't have a flashlight, I just have that stupid glowy thing, so let's go back to the mining helmet. I like it too much. Also, these black rim glasses, I've just realized, they look more like goggles. Like, they look okay, but compared to my other glasses. The eyeglasses. Yeah, the eyeglasses just look cooler. They look more like real glasses. I'll stick with those, even though these give perception instead of charisma. And I think I'd prefer the charisma over the perception. But it's fine. Style over substance. I'm gonna break my legs here. Nope. Got strong legs. Oh, just a dead end. Alright, well, let me see if I can make a crazy jump for this meat bag. Come on, gotta line this up. Oh. It was worth a shot. Ow. Ow. Eat some food. Let's go turn in the quest. Tell them I've cleared out the ghouls. Wakey wakey.
Took care of those ghouls that were giving you trouble.
You did?
Whoa.
That's great news. Lady, you and the Minutemen have our gratitude and our support.
That guy's a light sleeper, I guess. Jesus. Had a lot of coffee before you went to sleep?
Let's trade.
Go ahead.
Now he just sounds depressed. Razor grain. I'll take some of that. Yeah, for some reason, once you incorporate a settlement, you can trade with people, and you can just take their stuff. You don't have to pay for it, you can just take it. Here, why don't you equip the Ratstag hide outfit? There you go, buddy. Seems better than what you got before. You know what? Why don't you have the Field Scribe's armor? Yeah. There you go, you look all official and stuff. You look like a proper adventurer. Now why don't you go adventure where I don't have to hear your mediocre voice acting?
I just want to trade a few things.
Take your time.
Sure thing.
I'm just talking to her back now. What does that look like? That looks kind of cool. I'll take your ammunition. Alright, good day. I wonder if it matters if you take their ammunition. Like, if they actually go to defend the settlement, do they actually need ammo? Or do they just have, like, unlimited ammunition? I can't imagine they would actually need ammo. Because if so, then where would they ever replenish their ammo? Like, ever? Let's see if we can do some crafting. Okay, so I can... Have I incorporated the settlement to the point where I can now build? Yeah, so now I can build. Happiness is going down. They've only got two people. They need defense. Let's just make a really quick defense if we can. Do I have the stuff for turrets? I do not. Yeah, unfortunately, I found out that crafting components that are stored in the workshop are not actually shared between settlements. So... At Sanctuary, I have tons of stuff stored in the... At Sanctuary, I have tons of stuff stored in the workshop, and I can make tons of turrets. But here, I can't, because I don't actually have access to the stuff that's at Sanctuary. Now, you can set up supply lines to make it so that you do have a shared inventory between your settlements. but I don't have that yet. So I can't make turrets, I can't make anything fancy, because I've barely got anything stored here, but I could make a guard post. So, let's do that. And it'll face that away, I guess. Sure. There's only two people here. Somebody needs to tend the food. Somebody needs to guard. Where did you go? Where did the woman go? The guy went off into the greenhouse, but... Oh, there you are. Just hiding. Command you. This will make the defense go up.
Okay.
There we go, two defense. Hopefully that increases happiness. And that's about all I'm gonna do here. But yeah, if you did want the supply line thing to have a shared inventory between your settlements, you would need local leader. Yeah, you are able to establish supply lines between your workshop settlements, so I would need one more point in charisma, and then I need to put a point into this. Which I might want to do? Possibly. I don't know. Right. Time.
You hear about that farm run by ghouls? Isn't that something?
Could you point to me where it is on the map? I'd love to see it. Okay, let's go up north and check out Bunker Theta. Stingwings! Those things are nasty. Aw, come on. There we go. Level 14. Don't you bite me. Make some nice food from their meat. Just gotta find the bodies, they're so tiny. There was a third one. Ah, I don't know where it is. Oh, there we go, he woke up. I was gonna do something. Oh, right! Level up! Let me figure out what I want to put my point into. Ooh, gun nut. Gain access to rank 2 gun mods. Yeah, let's do it. Can't wait to get back to Sanctuary and see if I can slap anything new on my weapons. Especially this one. My two-shotty. I hear gunfire. Sounded like a small explosion. I feel like I'm gonna get ambushed if I go in the center there. Oh, who are those people? Raider scum, yep. Although, they're displayed as green. Doesn't that mean they're not hostile? And yeah, there's a frag mine there. So, trap. Hi.
Buddy.
Whoa. Okay, now they're hostile. Alright, well, you die. And then, no. Then you die. Don't need no scope. Now, where's that mine? There you are. Oh no, don't tell me I... Oh good, I don't have to hack it. Hi, you're still alive.
Freeze, one more step and I'll blow your damn head off. Who are you? Who sent you? How did you get in here?
Looks like Brandis has gone a bit crazy. Hold up in here. What were you doing, dog meat? That was a weird noise.
Easy now. I don't want any trouble.
No. I can't trust you. I can't trust you!
What? Seriously? I've got to kill him? Fuck. Do I really have to? I can't, like, pacify him? The quest says kill him. Alright. I'm sorry, man. You tried to murder me. What could I have done?
Excellent.
Survivor special. Does more damage the lower your health is. That's like a speedrun weapon or something. Hmm. Is it any good, though? Like, as it is right now. Is that a pistol? It looks kind of like a pistol. It's pretty, but I think it's a pistol and not a rifle, which means it doesn't fit with my class build. Oh, let's take a look at all the armor that I just picked off of him. See if any of it's better. That's not better. Not better. It's got really good radiation protection. I thought I picked up more. Hmm. So much freaking junk in here. Give me all of it. Even the battered clipboard. Good components in here. Wonder how long he's in here for. Weeks? Poor guy. Made it all this way. Survived. when the rest of his people didn't. And then I had to kill him. It's anticlimactic. After all that, it just ends with me murdering him. Well, no, not murdering him. Killing him. I was defending myself. And that's it. Huh. Oh well. Alright, let's go back to Sanctuary, dump our stuff, and see if we can do any rank 2 gun mods to our current weapons. Oh, and it looks like we've gained even more settlers, too. Last time I checked, at the beginning of the episode, it was 6, now it's 7. Which means I need to make more beds. Our people are gonna be unhappy. Transfer all junk, there we go. Alright, weapon mod time. What are you building? Let's see what we can do. Start with my two-shotter. Alright, let's look for the rank 2 ones. So that's rank 2. Okay, so that's the only rank 2. Superior damage, better critical shot damage, and accuracy. So, weighs more. Better critical shot damage and accuracy, and also just better damage. But how much better damage? 103. This makes it 128. Ooh, that's a big increase in damage. It's like 20% increase or so. More than that, actually. Alright, barrel. Rank 2. So this is the rank 2. Superior recoil, range, and sighted accuracy. Poor hipfire accuracy. That's fine. This gun is not for hipfiring. Although... it's not actually any better in range than the long barrel.
You're tied to this place, kid. Your energy.
But I guess it increases the recoil? I guess that's the only thing it increases more than the long barrel? Because otherwise the stats are the same. Let's go with that. Let's take a look at the stock. Marksman stock. Superior recoil, better aim with scopes. Man, this is gonna be a heavy rifle. Look at how much the weight is increasing with every mod. A pound here, a pound there. Soon enough, this thing's gonna weigh as much as a rocket launcher. Accuracy only goes up by 1. But it's also better recoil, so that'll be nice when I'm sniping with the scope on. Because, you know, when the scope jerks back, it jerks up super far when I'm taking a shot, it's really disorientating. So better recoil would be really nice. Oh, a better magazine would be good too.
But we're surviving.
Let's see. So this is rank 2, better ammo capacity and reload speed. Also adds a little bit more to the weight, quite a bit more to the value. Man, this game is really bad at giving you information sometimes. Like, better ammo capacity and reload speed. Okay, how much better ammo capacity? As far as I can tell, nowhere does it actually say how much ammunition it allows you to hold in one magazine. And also, how much faster the reload speed is. But it's gotta be better. Let's go with that. Medium scope.
Sure, let me just stop what I'm doing to talk to you. I'm being sarcastic. Leave me alone.
Could make the long scope, but I'm missing one screw. Well, that's not gonna happen. Muzzle. Muzzle brake. Or compensator. Both of those are rank 2. Improved per-shot recoil, improved recoil control, reduced range. The range is still fine, honestly. From 215 to 203, that's fine. What does this do? Exceptional recoil control, better per-shot recoil, inferior range. It still doesn't make that big of a difference to the range, honestly. Not to mention, it looks really cool. I'm gonna build it. Holy crap, look at how cool this gun looks now. Look at that.
What are you building?
Let's take a look at this thing. Wow! That looks so freaking cool. This thing just went from looking just like a pretty cool World War II rifle to looking like a modern, tricked out beast. Alright, let's see the recoil. Oh, and the magazine too. So now it holds 7 shots instead of 5. Let's see what the recoil is. Is that really better? I feel like that's just as bad as it was before. It's still completely disorientating. Ah, whatever. Alright, now let's see the reload speed. That's so much better. Wow. Because before I didn't even have a magazine, right? I just had to like manually load in each round, I think. This thing is just... Oh, I love this rifle. Let's go see what else we can trick out. I guess my next most used weapon would be Righteous Authority. Oh, wait, but I need science for that, right? Standard grip. Yeah, I need science for that. Although I could maybe put a scope on it. But no, once again, I want a reflex sight. I don't want a short scope. Because this thing needs to be able to hip fire really well. And any sort of an actual scope that you have to zoom into just has too much downtime. It needs to be basically instant. Okay, well, aside from that, what else do I kind of use? Well, there's the cryolator, of course. But that doesn't have too many mods, because it's such a specialist weapon. All the mods that I did want to put on it have already been put in there. Also, some dude just teleported into the background there. Cool. Other than that, I suppose I use this, rarely. Yeah, I use this thing so rarely, honestly, I don't want to even bother putting stuff into it. Yeah. Nah, that'll use up precious screws, and I do not have many screws. In fact, you could even say if I use too many screws, I might be screwed. Sorry. Let me show you a bit of base building. Yeah, I usually cut most of it out, but in this case I know exactly what I want to do, and it should be relatively quick. So I'm going to ring the bell, get everybody to come here, because we have new settlers and I want to assign them to jobs. So everybody will slowly, very, 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 very slowly come to the bell. Let's give them 5 hours, and while we're waiting... While we're waiting, you can see we have 7 people, but only 5 beds. Let's build a couple beds. And let's build them in the new place that I just made. It's more warehousey than bed-like, but whatever. I can even fit beds here. In the corners. Nah. You know what, let's give this place some room to expand. Because more people will probably show up. So let's plop down some more beds. Let's just make this a bunk. This is just a barracks. There. And the lights never go out, so you'll never be able to sleep. They have to sleep next to a freaking generator. Oh my god, can you imagine actually sleeping in this little tin house that's constantly lit? That loud-ass generator right next to your head. Whoops, no, don't store it. Alright, everybody should be gathered. Indeed they are. Let's assign some more people to... farming? Or is everybody already doing farming? I don't know, let's see. You're new. I command you... to take care of... this.
Sure.
Our food is still at 19, so... Nah, that didn't change anything. Okay, we have enough farmers. In that case, honestly, I have nothing to assign them to. I need to build more, like, guard posts or something. Which, I suppose I probably should do. So you know what? I'll show you a little bit more building. Let's build some defenses. Clean up that garbage. Let's go reinforce the bridge. There's that recruitment tower that I built. Oh, you know what? I actually don't think I have anybody assigned to this guard post. I've got someone assigned to that one, but not this one. Alright, who wants to volunteer? This is what sucks about one of the many, many things that sucks about the interface when it comes to settlements is that you have to manually run over to somebody you want to assign to something. What are you assigned to right now? I don't know. You've got a new job, come with me. You have to run over to them, press E on them, and then you have to run back to the thing you want them to do. It's really annoying. You should be able to just say assign on an object and then just like select from a list of settlement people or something like that. It could be easily made so much better. That didn't seem to make our defenses go up. Was somebody already assigned to it? I didn't think they were. You know what? I'm gonna call it a day. Good enough. Game doesn't want to provide me with a good interface to actually tell what the hell's going on, but fine. Hey Sturgis, I've got something for you.
You can fix just about anything. Guns, computers, people. Just gotta have the right tools.
I'd like to trade some items.
I would like you to have this.
Most people are good at breaking things. I enjoy putting them back together.
There you go. Alright, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I am going to go talk to Preston Garvey, dump some of my stuff off screen to free up some weight, and then I guess probably do some more settlement quests or some random exploring.